Radio Network on Telstar 5 Transponder 5 and on the internet at realityradionetwork.com.
And now, Sherry Schreiner Live.
Welcome to the show. I'm Sherry Schreiner. Listener call in line tonight, 260-356-2611. A lot of feedback this week, and I wanted to answer an email from a listener. I just pulled up here. Got a couple questions in here from during the week. I want to go over some of his questions. I love your show and watch it all the time. I imagine he means he listens to it all the time. I have a few questions to ask. I am currently living in South Florida and planning to move. What is the safest place to move to? I don't care how isolated it is. I just want to keep my family and friends safe. Could you please list some places? I don't really know, other than just getting inside and away from coastlines and away from the Mississippi River. I wouldn't move up towards that either. Exactly what is the safest places? I know Missouri and the northern part of Arkansas, that whole area seems to be pretty safe. Parts of Ohio, West Virginia, pretty safe areas. So you're really just going to have to seek the Lord on where he wants you to move. If he's leading you to get away from the area you're in, seek him to lead you as to where to move. He's not going to tell you to move and then not tell you where to go. So just listen to him. Pay attention to that nagging, the reoccurring thoughts that keep coming on where to go. Another question is, are there any good or helpful aliens at all? And I get blasted for this one all the time from the aliens who think they're good, for referring to all aliens as being bad. And obviously there's outright bad and hostile aliens. And on the other hand, there appears to be aliens that are helpful, and I say appears to be, because you have to be careful. A lot of them may be helping mankind in the meantime, teaching mankind doctrines of the devils, doctrine of the devil himself, things that are not of the Lord. They don't believe in the Lord Jesus Christ or Yahushua. They lead astray, people stray into pagan and New Age doctrines. And just because one isn't hostile doesn't mean he doesn't have a different agenda. From what I can tell, from aliens I've heard of and came, heard from others, is that they all just have their own agenda. If they're, you know, they each have their own agenda. You have to remember that aliens are fallen angels. They are the children of fallen angels. If they were standing and good angels, they would be in heaven with the Most High. And so all of these that we would consider as aliens are in a fallen state. And the Lord has never led me to stay or become in contact with any of these alien beings. He can use them for his purposes. He can use them in regards to anything he wants to use them for. But we're to seek him. We're to seek him. We're not to get involved with worship of angels. And especially some of these New Age and pagan practices will lead you into necromancy, which is talking to the dead, which is forbidden by the Lord, talking to dead spirits. So you have to be really careful about that. I know there was a lot of people that were, you know, were abductees of UFOs and aliens and thought they were nice and helpful. And finally, dawned on them, and they finally saw for themselves the dark side agenda of these beings, that they weren't who they were masquerading themselves as, that they appeared to be friendly and helpful, but on the backside, ended up being truly evil, and these people becoming afraid of them. And so, you just have to follow the Lord on that, folks, and use discernment and wisdom. You know, like I said, if they were standing angels, they would be in heaven with the Most High. And so all of these alien beings we're dealing with are fallen angels in a fallen state or from parents who had rebelled. And so you just have to seek the Lord on that. Another question is, all of the stuff about meditating and being able to levitate, read minds, and astral projection a lie? No, it's not a lie. These are things that can actually be done. But who's behind it? You know, if there's only two sources behind all things, one being God, the other being Satan, who's the source behind it? You know, does the Most High teach us to meditate things? Does he teach us to levitate things? Does he teach us to read minds or astral project? I mean, astral projection is a whole realm of Satan's playground, and I've talked about that on the show last couple of weeks about the astral realm. And so you have to understand that all these things are accomplished through demonic sources. You know, you can't levitate something with, when people, you know, these Eastern religions where you levitate something with your mind, and what they don't see is a demon standing underneath it just holding it up. What you're doing is summoning demons by your meditations. And so it's like, there's always a dark side to things. If it's, there's only two sources of all things, it's either God or it's Satan. You're either using him or you're using Satan and his demonic forces. Meditating, in the sense that most people use it today in religions, is not good. Most of it is being used to manipulate your own mind, to blank it out so that it can be controlled by demonic sources, by demonic beings. When David or anybody in the Bible referred to meditation, it was focusing and thinking on the Lord. You know, you're meditating on him, you're thinking on him, you're being focused on him. It wasn't this blanking out your mind stuff, going into a trance state, so that your mind could be easily manipulated by demonic forces. And so it's two different things, folks. They took meditation, ran with it for a mile, and now we have the demonic aspect of it that it is today when you hear of meditation. You never want to blank out your mind. You always want to be in control of your own mind, because if you're not in control of your mind, something else is going to take control of it. You know, it's an easy out. It's an easy way of getting manipulated by demons and even possessed by them. Another question, there's a magician on A&E every Wednesday at 10 p.m. called Chris Angel, and I've seen this guy's website online. He can walk on walls, levitate, read minds, and teleport. He does everything on the street surrounded by people and uses no props. He promotes the power of the mind, body, and soul. What is your opinion on him? Chris Angel is a hybrid. He's obviously one of these people, Rick from StarGods.org talked about, who is self-aware of who he is. They use those words, self-aware. Obviously a hybrid, and it's demonic sources that give him the power and the ability to be able to do what he's doing. And, you know, you can go to his website. He's got a website online. And he just does all these supernatural things. And you know what? So is the false prophet. Wait till the false prophet comes. And he starts performing all these supernatural feats. And then gives his power and praise to Satan, to Lucifer. And says he gets his power and from him. And he promotes this Antichrist as God. This Satan as God. You know, these things are coming. We're going to see a lot more of supernatural feats and people with supernatural abilities. These hybrids becoming more and more bold throughout our society. They are not pure humans.